Hi, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. Now, I'm going to start this off with a little bit of a backstory so you guys kind of get the concept of what I'm doing here. I have a really close friend of mine, we've been friends for almost 20 years at this point, who lives in Virginia. I now live in Florida, Central Florida, and we're maybe a two-hour plane ride away from each other. 2 years ago, just over 2 years ago, he was my best man in my wedding, and I gave him as a groomsman gift a modified pre-built PC. It was a custom case with a Dell reference board and a Core 2 Duo E7500, clocked at 2.83 or 2.93 gigahertz. And it had 6 gigs of RAM and a HD 3870 video card. By no means was this a powerhouse machine, but it was an upgrade for him because he was coming from like a decrepit old company laptop, which barely could function. Let alone play a game and Skype at the same time, or any of your choice VoIP processes. So it was a significant upgrade in his department, and I felt really good building a computer for, you know, my best friend. So that was awesome. I built it to him, shipped it to him, and it's lasted this long. Now fast forward just over 2 years later, and I've since shipped him a video card, or actually gave him a video card last time he was visiting Washington State, and he upgraded from 3870 that he had to a 6850, which is an old card I had laying around. So he now has had this computer for a little over 2 years. He has a slightly better video card, but he's noticing that the performance isn't all that great. And then on top of that, he's starting to have some issues where it's getting too hot, it's shutting down, it's, you know, maybe got some dust accumulating in parts and pieces that he doesn't really know about. And for the most, it's just kind of lacking some maintenance, in my opinion. So stack that on top of the fact that we haven't seen each other in a long time, and I kind of thought this is a perfect opportunity to visit my friend, help him fix his computer, and maybe surprise him a little bit in the process. I decided to cut the audio out of this portion of the video and kind of dive in on an audio track, just because I felt I got a little convoluted in the way I was describing some of this, and it could have been done in a bit more of a direct way. So basically what we upgraded his computer with is a Gigabyte Micro ATX board, pretty compact board, not a whole lot of options for IO and different connections, but nonetheless still a very good board for what we're trying to do. We went with a Core i3-6100, so the newest dual core, clocked at 3.7 gigahertz. We went with 8 gigs of HyperX Fury memory, and we went with a 500 gig Western Digital hard drive, and just a generic gaming set from, I want to say, Sadez. I honestly don't really know how to pronounce the name. I'm sure someone can correct me on that. Nonetheless, I made these choices for a couple big reasons. One is cost, and two, I knew the kind of gaming that that David's going to be doing with his computer. And the cost was a big factor in terms of where I wanted to spend the money. I wanted to get the most I could get for the money I had to spend replacing his motherboard, processor, and RAM. From there, I wanted a good upgrade path for him, something that I knew I could rely on to get him to a better spec down the road if he decides to go a little more heavy on the gaming side of things and play some more games that are devoted towards some more multitasking, so an i5 and some more RAM down the road, as well as a better video card than what he currently has. And then on top of that, if you look at the i3 and you compare it to, say, the FX 4350, I want to say it's the quad core, and the FX 6300 and the FX 8350 or 6350, all of those different processors, you'll notice that the i3 will beat the 6300 and the 4350 in most of, maybe it's a 4850, I'm not entirely sure, but nonetheless, it'll beat the AMD equivalent of cost for quad core, it'll beat the AMD 6 core, and it'll tie the AMD 8 core, if not beat it out on a few different things. Now, obviously, if you get into super multitasking where cores are going to win you the performance test, obviously the AMD systems are going to do that. But games like StarCraft 2, most modern games or games that are slightly older in the last 5 years, they're not going to utilize more than a couple cores. And so at this point, a Core i3 is a great processor for him. It's going to be have a lot more efficient than an AMD version. In terms of equivalent cost. And then on top of that, it's going to give him a direct upgrade path to an i5 or an i7. Now, don't get me wrong, is he going to go buy an i7 and dump it into this bare bones machine? Probably not. But he could feasibly dump a couple $100 into an i5 down the road and have a good usable quad core machine running an Intel architecture that really can.
Right now, my YouTube channel is in its infancy, and I don't get any of this stuff to review for free. This all came out of my pocket. So by all means, please support, subscribe, and you know, keep the views coming, because that's going to help me be able to help you guys have more content like this to be able to show you how to build machines on the cheap. That's really what I'm focused at, because I know there are a lot of people out there like myself who have to bargain bin shop for a lot of things to even get something to function, let alone get something to perform really well. So with all that said, thank you very much for watching. I know it was kind of a long video. I just kind of get long-winded sometimes. So I apologize. I'll do my best to kind of cut those things back and really stay focused on what we're doing. Have a great day, a great night, a great week or month until I see you guys next. Appreciate all the support. Bye.